In order to communicate with Linux, we must first configure our Server 2008. Since Server 2008 has a built-in SMB protocol, Samba Server allows us to share files between different operating systems. To successfully establish a working connection with Samba, a router is needed to route which information goes to which computer. Our video tutorial is divided into two parts. Part 1 deals with finding out information about a router and network configurations. Part 2 deals with configuring Windows Server 2008 to establish a connection with Samba. Let's get started. We're going to find out the configuration of our router in Part 1. To do that, we have to open the Windows command prompt inside of our host computer by clicking on Start, All Programs, Accessories, then Command Prompt. Then, type in ipconfig and press enter. The ipconfig command tells Windows to display a list of information that is related to the host computer's network router. There are three important pieces of information that we need to write down. Network IP address or IPv4 address, subnet mask, and default gateway. These numbers will be important later on. In part 2, we're going to configure our Windows Server 2008. One important thing we need to keep in mind is that computers only communicate among each other if they are connected to the same network. This basically means that Windows Server 2008 and Samba will have to connect to the same default gateway and subnet mask that we saw earlier. In addition, the first three sections of our network IP address have to stay the same. This tells our router that these computers are locally connected to the same network. The only section that is different is the fourth section of our network IP address. So if our IP address is 192.168.0.123, the other computer's IP address has to start with 192.168.0 and end in a number that is not 123. To configure our Server 2008, open VirtualBox and boot up the Server 2008 virtual machine. After our Server 2008 is booted up into the desktop screen, click on Start, then right-click on Network and select Properties. This screen is where we can configure most of our network settings. First, we need to allow computers on our network to be able to discover and share information by turning on public folder sharing. To do that, go to Network Discovery, File Sharing, and then Public Folder Sharing. Select Apply and choose Appropriate Network Type. Next, we're going to configure the network IP address, gateway, and subnet mask by clicking on the Manage Network Connections. A new window will pop up with a virtual local area connection icon. Right-click on the local area connection icon and select Properties. Next, select Internet Protocol Version 4 and click on the Properties button. Another window will pop up and allow us to modify our internet settings. Then select Use the following IP address radio button. Type in the default gateway and subnet mask that we saw earlier in the command prompt window. Under IP address, type in the first three sections of the IP address that was in the command prompt. An example would be 192.168.0. In the fourth section of the IP address, we will change it to our desired settings. Make sure the fourth section of the IP address does not match with other computers on our network, because if they do, the computers will have an IP conflict. An IP conflict is what happens when two computers with the same IP address connect to the same network. They will not be able to communicate with each other if that happens. To make sure two computers don't conflict, we should draw a simple network diagram that states which computers are using what IP address. For example, Server 2008 would use 192.168.0.10. Then our Samba machine will use a different IP address, such as 192.168.0.20 or 192.168.0.30. Next, select Use the following DNS server addresses and type in the IP address of the default gateway from the command prompt. Click on OK and then Close to finish with the configuration. Go ahead and close the configuration window too. Now we're going to change the computer and workgroup name. To do that, click on Start. Right-click on Computer and select Properties. A system window will pop up. To change the computer name and workgroup settings, click on Change Settings. A system property window will pop up. Click on the Change button to modify the setting. Under the computer name box, type in the new distinctive computer name. Make sure it is different from other computers on our network. Under Workgroup box, type in Workgroup. This is the name of our network. Click on OK and OK again. Then close and restart the computer to finish with our configuration. For our server 2008 to make modified changes, we need to restart our system. After we restart, we should be able to connect to a Samba share. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.